This video gives you a quick overview of the miniVSAT manager and the valuable network management tools that are available there. If you're a miniVSAT broadband subscriber, you can access miniVSAT manager over any internet connection. First, go to the customer portal at mykvh.com and log in. Your password is available from our airtime services department. Once you're logged in, click the Go button next to miniVSAT manager. First, you'll see your vessel's location on the map. The location is based on the latest update. If you manage a fleet of vessels, it'll show you the locations of all your vessels. You can zoom in or out, or zoom to a specific area on the map. Click on the vessel icon to view the status of its VSAT system or systems. The antenna icon is color-coded. If it's green, the system is online. Orange means the system has been offline for more than an hour, and gray means the system has been offline for more than 2 days. Now let's dive deeper into a vessel's VSAT system. Select Details from the pop-up window, or click the Details button next to the vessel's name in the sidebar. The Vessel Details page provides complete data usage, status, and network information for the VSAT system. As you can see, you can easily open or close slices of information on this page, so you can simplify the screen as much as you like. Let's view the Data Plan section. Here you can see the plan you're subscribed to, the maximum upload and download speeds you can expect under the plan, and the estimated amount of data your vessel has consumed during the current billing cycle. This information is provided for both the high-speed channel and the unlimited channel. Depending on your antenna type and subscription, your screen may appear differently. For example, if you have a backup Iridium system, you will have the option to view its data as shown here. If you are subscribed to the Elite service, you will see the Elite option rather than high speed. If you have a V3 HDS, your screen may look like this. Let's look at the high speed channel, since that's where we'll find usage management. Note the separate usage bars. This one indicates how much of your monthly allowance you have used, and this one how much you've gone beyond it. Please be aware that all usage estimates refresh every 15 minutes, except the daily billing table, which is refreshed daily. To view usage data in more detail, scroll down to the Application Reporting section. Keep in mind that settings may vary depending on your subscription or antenna type. Here you can see each day's usage sorted into categories. Each category bundles numerous network identifiers that generally relate to the same type of applications. For example, you can see this vessel enjoys a lot of real-time entertainment, which is streaming services like Netflix and YouTube. The next largest percentage is basic web browsing. Then comes real-time communication, that is, chat or calling apps like WhatsApp and Skype. You can see entertainment usage spiked on the 5th and the 17th. If usage in any category is unacceptably high, you can use category controls to block or restrict it. First, select Change Category Controls, then make your selections. Another way to help control data usage is to set up alerts to notify you whenever usage exceeds certain thresholds. Just set your thresholds and add the email addresses or phone numbers of those you want to be notified. It's that simple. All triggered alerts are listed here in the activity log. In addition to alerts, you can control your vessel's data usage by setting up data allocations. Setup is a three-step process. First, set the vessel's ICM to any network configuration that enforces user logins. Second, create allocation profiles that set the maximum amount of data a user can consume within a daily, weekly, or monthly period. Lastly, create a user login and assign one of your allocation profiles to every person on board your vessel. Anyone connecting to the high-speed or crew network will then need to enter their username and password to access the internet. Once a user has consumed the data allotment for the current period, access is denied until the next period begins. Of course, if you find you need to grant someone more or less data, you can always return to miniVSAT Manager and modify allocations. You can also modify the system's network configuration and Wi-Fi settings, unless KVH has set up a custom configuration for your vessel. When you save changes here, They are applied to the ICM on the vessel within minutes, assuming the VSAT system is online. So before you make a change, be sure you understand the network implications and setup requirements. Refer to the system's installation guide or help center for details. In addition, if you turn on the ICM's Wi-Fi, don't forget to protect it with a password. Okay, now let's return to the map page. Here you can view coverage areas and customize your map settings. To view the combined coverage area of all beams in the network, select Coverage Maps from the Settings menu. Select HTS Network to view your coverage options. If you manage a fleet and monitor vessels with different KVH antenna models, you'll be able to view coverage based on antenna type. C-band coverage applies only to V11 models. You can also overlay different views onto the map. We have one more feature to talk about, vessel tracking. You can get to the vessel track page at any time by clicking the track button next to the vessel's name in the sidebar. This page shows the historical track and speed of your vessel. By default, you'll see the track for the past 5 hours. You'll also see the speed over the past hour. If you purchase premium tracking, you'll be able to view the track and speeds for any hour, day, week, or month within the last year. You'll also have access to position reports that you can save to a spreadsheet or database. This concludes our brief tour of the miniVSAT Manager. We hope you take advantage of everything it has to offer. To learn more about any of the features we touched upon, please check out the associated topic in the help.